This is a quick guide on how to share your files and folders between all your systems that are connected to the same network. You don't need to download any extra tools, everything can be done within Windows 10 itself. I'll also be showcasing how to access those files even if your host machine is not online all the time, as well as how to pin your local network folder into the taskbar for very easy access. Now let's get started. Alrighty, so first we're gonna open up File Explorer, and on the left bar you can see the network icon. Click on that to see all the computers that are currently connected to your local network. And then once you find the computer that you wanna access or log into, you can double click on it and it will ask for your credentials. Now these credentials mean your local username and password, so basically what you use to log into your computer. In some cases, you might not remember your username because you usually just need to input the password. So to figure out your username, go to your other computer that you're trying to connect to and in the search bar, type in account info. That will open up all the details about your account and also show your account username at the top. And this is the username you have to type into the login screen. Once you figured it out, just click on remember my credentials, you don't need to type it in again. Click OK and you should be logged in. If you see it as empty, that means you're successfully logged in, you just haven't shared any folders yet. In some cases on Windows 10, network discovery is turned off by default, which was the case on my secondary PC. And you will get this error when clicking on the network thing. To fix this, just click on the notification at the top and just enable network discovery. After that, you should see all the local devices as normal. Now we finally get to the actual sharing of folders or files. To do that, obviously first you need to figure out which folder or file you want to share. And in my case, I'm going to share this techtipvault.com folder to share project files between my two computers. Now select the file or folder and click on share at the very top. And then click on share with specific people. And that should open up a prompt where you can select who to share with. And from the dropdown, you can just select a specific user or you can just select everyone. If you choose to share with everyone, they still need to be connected to your local network and know your username and password, so you should be fine. Once you selected the rights and click OK, you should see this confirmation that says your folder is shared. Now, as you can see, we have one text file in this folder and it should be visible on our main PC. So now that we go to the other system and log into our network folder, we see this new shared folder and guess what? There is the text file inside of it. We have successfully shared a folder and all the contents of that folder. In order to double check that it works both ways, we're just gonna add a random picture into the folder on the main PC. And then move over to the secondary one and press F5 to refresh and boom, the picture is there instantly. In these examples that I just showed you, both PCs were on connected to the internet at the same time. Now, if the secondary PC which I created the folder with was actually turned off, I would not be able to access the files on the main PC. Thankfully, there's a way to view these files even if either system is offline, and we're gonna see how to do that next. Okay, so in order to accomplish offline viewing of these folders, you need to go on the non-host machine, right-click on the folder, and select Always Available Offline. This will copy all the files onto your C drive into a specific folder, and it will create a new icon. You can see the little green circle next to the folder, which means that the folder has been synchronized for offline use. That green circle is the Windows Sync Center icon, which can now also be found in the taskbar, and it has a option for sync all, and once you click it, your files will synchronize between your both of your systems. Obviously, when you're doing the synchronization, the host machine has to be online since the files are never stored online, only locally. The main differences between the Sync Center and non-Sync Center you should realize is that the Sync Center stores all the files on both machines and you need to manually click the Sync All button every time there's an update. While if you're not using the Sync Center, the files always update live, but you need to have your host machine online at all times. when you're using the Sync Center, you can check how much space the files are taking from your C drive by going to the Sync Center and clicking Manage Offline Files on the left. Then click on Disk Usage, which will show you the live amount of space, and you can also change the maximum amounts. This will prevent you from accidentally filling up your entire PC if someone puts something huge in the folder. The actual files themselves are stored under C, Windows, CSC. And this folder cannot be changed very easily, but if you want to know how to do that, then just leave a comment and I'll help you out. So now you pretty much know everything you probably came here for, but for the last part we're gonna cover how to access that local network folder a lot faster through a quick shortcut or how to pin it to your taskbar even, which is not as simple as just dragging and dropping, which seems to be a very common case for Windows 10. The fastest and easiest way to make it easy to access your folder is by right-clicking on it and clicking on Pin to Quick Access. This will pin it on the left side of this PC view / folder, and also in the bottom on File Explorer. If you right click on it, you will see it in the pinned options, which will also open the folder. But that still requires two whole clicks, which is not what we're about, so let's figure out how to pin it to the taskbar. As you can see here, simply dragging and dropping it to the taskbar does absolutely nothing. What you need to do is right click on the desktop and select New and Shortcut. This will open up the Shortcut Creation tool. Click on the Browse button and look for your shared folder in the network. Once you find it, select it and click OK. And now this is where the magic happens. What you need to do is type Explorer in the beginning of the path and then surround the actual path itself with double quotes. And that's all you need to do. Then just click on Next and type in an appropriate name for your shortcut. Now our epic shortcut is ready and it can be pinned to the taskbar just by dragging it. The only issue is that it's real ugly. In order to change the folder icon into something sexier, right click on it, go to Properties and select Change Icon. Now as you can see, all these default Windows 10 icons are really ugly. But if you go to Browse and then Windows System 32 and look for a file called imageres.dll, there are a lot more better looking icons hidden away inside of that file. Obviously, you can just as well get your own icons online just by googling cool icons whatnot, and you can browse it just the same. But for the purpose of this tutorial, I wanted to show you a good selection of icons that you can find without having to download anything extra. And once you find the one you like, just click on OK and OK again, and you're good to go. As you can see, you can now drag the shortcut to your taskbar and it looks beautiful and works perfectly, opens up the folder as it should. And the best part is, you can actually now delete the shortcut from your desktop and it will still continue working just fine. Another reason why it's very good to make a shortcut like this is because when your host PC is offline, it will not actually show up in your network devices, which means you can still access it via the shortcut, but you cannot access it via the network folders as seen here. This is obviously only helpful if you have enabled the Windows Sync Center to view the files offline. And finally, a quick tidbit is if you open up a file explorer and type into the search bar /localhost, you can see every single folder that you have actually shared on your PC, which helps keep track of everything you've shared. If you had any issues with anything, just leave a comment and tell me what you thought about the video, and I'll see you in the next one.